Let's take a look at Javadoc Comments. IntelliJ IDEA can render these in the editor, making it easier for you to view and understand what's going on. It also means your code won't be overloaded with tags. You can render a Javadoc with Ctrl, Option and Q on Mac, or Ctrl, Alt and Q for Windows and Linux. If you want to change the size of the font once it's been rendered, you can right-click and select Adjust Font Size. If you want to go back and edit your Javadoc comment, you can use the same shortcut again, Ctrl, Option and Q on Mac, or Ctrl, Alt and Q on Windows and Linux. Alternatively, you can click the icon in the gutter on line 10, and that will also toggle the rendering of the Javadoc comment. You can also render images. I'm going to cheat slightly and use my clipboard history to paste in a remote image link. Once again, Ctrl, Option and Q on the Mac, or Ctrl, Alt and Q on Windows and Linux, and our remote image is rendered. Of course, you can also render local images as well. Again, I'm going to use my clipboard history to paste in my local image link, and this time I'll use the gutter icon to render the Javadoc. There's our remote image, and here's our local image. We can also render links as well. For example, I can add this link here, and now I can see both my remote and local image and the link that I've just added. If you always want to render Javadocs in your project, there are a couple of ways you can achieve that. You can either right-click and select Render All Doc Comments. Alternatively, you can go into your Settings and Preferences with Command and Comma on Mac or Control Alt and S on Windows and Linux, and then search for Render Doc. Go down to Appearance, Render Documentation Comments, and click OK. That means that Javadoc comments will always be rendered in your project. ¶¶